In New Orleans, Dr. Facilier makes his deals and uses his voodoo magic in hopes of gaining wealth and power. He's pretty smooth, possesses practically unlimited abilities, and even admits,
"I'm a royal myself on my mother's side."
He seemed set up for success, but how did he get here? How did he become a wielder of voodoo magic, and is he really a royal? Hello, I'm Isaac from Watso Videos, where we discuss fun topics for fun people, and today I'm going to explain Dr. Facilier's royal lineage, voodoo, and past. Before we can understand Dr. Facilier's voodoo magic and background, first we need to understand what voodoo actually is and where it came from. Voodoo is a religion created in the Americas which derived from the syncretizing or merging of numerous African religions, primarily the West African Dahomeyan, Vodun, and Catholicism. Depending on the region where the syncretization occurred, different versions of voodoo arose, such as the Deep South voodoo, Haitian voodoo, and the version we will primarily focus on, Louisiana voodoo, since this is the region the Princess and the Frog takes place in. This merging of religions occurred as early as the 1700s due to the dispersal of African people to the Americas for enslavement. In Louisiana, there were Fon people from what is now Benin, along with other groups such as the Bambara, Mandinga, Fon, Congo, and many more who brought their cultural practices, languages, and religious beliefs rooted in spirit and ancestor worship together to create this new religion. All of the groups were responsible for the development of Louisiana voodoo. Under Louisiana voodoo, followers believe in a supreme creator known as Bondi, who is distant from the world and humanity. To communicate with their god, they utilize intermediaries known as Loa. These are Dr. Facilier's friends from the other side. The Loa aren't deities, but they are prayed to and expect humans to serve them. Each Loa is a distinct being with their own personal likes and dislikes, distinct sacred rhythms, songs, dances, ritual symbols, and special modes of service. In Dr. Facilier's case, he decides to serve Loa, longing for the souls of man. But Dr. Facilier doesn't just have voodoo.
I got voodoo, I got hoodoo, I got things I ain't even tried.
Unlike voodoo, hoodoo is neither a religion nor a denomination of a religion. It is a form of folk magic that originated in West Africa and is mainly practiced today in the southern United States. The goal of hoodoo practice is to allow people to harness supernatural forces in order to improve their daily lives. To accomplish these improvements, hoodoo tradition emphasizes personal magical power invoked by the use of certain tools, spells, formulas, methods, and techniques, and it declares magical properties to herbs, roots, minerals, animal parts, and personal possessions. To learn to perform hoodoo, teachings are passed down from one practitioner to another, each with unique rituals varying depending on the individual performing them. This means at some point, Facilier was taught his hoodoo from another, but we will get back to who his teacher is later. In Princess and the Frog, we see Dr. Facilier at his most powerful. Over many years, he has hoarded strange objects and voodoo paraphernalia like his crocodile teeth necklace, which practitioners believe can bring strength, primal energy, and wisdom to an individual. He has so many objects he admits he hasn't even tried them all. He is maximizing his use of hoodoo and voodoo and works as a voodoo boker. Conventionally, bokers are like sorcerers who are known to serve the Loa with both hands, meaning they practice both good and evil. In reality though, Facilier only uses his magic for evil, indicating he is a left-handed boker or a user of petro voodoo. Bokers like Facilier are infamous for using black magic for themselves, most commonly remembered as using their magic to create zombies and form oangas, or talismans that house spirits. Unfortunately for the Shadow Man, the nature of Facilier's voodoo from the Loa leaves Dr. Facilier unable to conjure a thing for himself. Instead, he must rely on gifts like the Gris-Gris Talisman and Guile to manipulate other people into doing what he wants, most frequently making deals with them in the process. He distracts and mesmerizes individuals with his sleight of hand and effortless manipulation of his card deck. He is also a master of lies and is incredibly persuasive, charismatic, and cunning, commonly only displaying the truth to an extent to bring individuals to make deals that will surely only benefit him. To further his influence over his victims, Dr. Facilier uses his petro voodoo to look into the past of individuals to learn their desires, displays their history to them on his tarot cards, conjures objects like his staff and tarot deck out of nothing, and manipulates individuals' bodies. interestingly enough, tarot cards are actually not related to the voodoo religion and were actually used for divination in 18th century Europe, but nevertheless, he uses them. Throughout Dr. Facilier's life, he perfected the use of magic, making deals with the Loa, and learning everything he could on voodoo and hoodoo. But why did he do this? How did he become a shadow man? Traditionally, voodoo bokers, like Facilier, are determined for this role at their birth when they are believed to possess a great gift in magic, meaning he has literally spent his whole life preparing to utilize this magic. And why was he born with so much power? Well, that's because of his royal blood.
I'm a royal myself on my mother's side.
It turns out in voodoo cultures, there were people known as voodoo queens. According to a census of 1731 to 1732, the ratio of enslaved Africans to European settlers in the French colonies that are now Louisiana were about 2-1, allowing influencing figures like voodoo queens to exercise great power in their communities. These women not only led their communities, but also had the role of leading many of their ceremonial meetings and ritual dances, drawing crowds of hundreds and thousands of people. Their power and influence were widespread and largely incontestable, recognized by journalists, judges, criminals, and citizens alike. These females of African and Creole descent emerged as powerful leaders in a society that upheld an oppressive slave regime. The queens, similarly to Dr. Facilier, made a living off of selling and administering amulets or gris-gris, charms, and magical powders, as well as spells and charms that guaranteed to cure ailments, grant desires, and confound or destroy one's enemies. Among the 15 voodoo queens in neighborhoods scattered around 19th century New Orleans, Mary Laveau was known as the voodoo queen and was the most eminent and powerful of them all. Everyone would come to her for advice. Even politicians, lawyers, businessmen, wealthy planters all came to her to consult her wisdom before making an important financial or business-related decision. Once the news of her power spread, she dominated the other voodoo leaders of New Orleans. When Dr. Facilier states he's a royal, he's referencing one of the famous voodoo queens of Louisiana, explaining his powerful connection with the Loa and the reason he was chosen to be a voodoo boker. Although we may never know who his mother actually is, originally Mama Odie was planned to be Dr. Facilier's mother, but this idea was scrapped. Even though Mama Odie isn't Facilier's mother, this concept supports the idea he came from a family with strong roots in voodoo and hoodoo, and I think his family were the ones who trained him. My guess is either the queen herself or one of the queen's descendants taught Facilier the rituals to implement hoodoo and connect with the Loa through voodoo, turning him into a powerful sorcerer. But his drive for power could never be stopped. Although Dr. Facilier was set up for success, he overextends himself in pursuit of power and his deals with the Loa comes to a sour end. He had to give up his own soul to pay back his debts. So now it's time for the question of the day, sponsored by my patrons. Do you think Dr. Facilier descended from a voodoo queen? Let me know your thoughts in the comments section, along with any other ideas you have for future Discovering Disney episodes. With Halloween approaching, I have made and am planning a lot of fun and spooky videos. So if you'd like to stay up to date with new magical videos, then click that subscribe button and follow me on Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram. To see more WOTSO videos, then check out some awesome pics over there. And as always, thanks for watching. And have a magical day.